Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, I'm going to be using Abbyy FineReader PDF 16 to add form fields into a PDF. Now, this document was already created in Microsoft Word and converted over to PDF. So now I'm going to use the form options within Abbyy FineReader. To begin, I'm going to select the form editor on the far right side. This brings up a drop-down menu where I can add important fields like text fields, checkboxes, radio buttons, drop-down lists, list box, buttons, or a signature. Let's start with our text field. I'm going to select the text field button and then drag and drop where I want this text field to be. And we can right-click the text field and select properties. This will bring up several options that we can adjust. For example, my field name is currently text field one. I'm going to change it to first name. And the tooltip will be, please enter your first name. We can also set settings like max number of symbols allowed, required, or read only. Let's select the appearance tab. And this is where we can change the fill color of the form field or the different font sizes. Or we can use this area to update the font size and font color of the typable text. If we select the format option, this is where we can choose either text or date and either single line or multi-line. Let's select OK. Now, because this field is already created, I can simply Control C or copy it, and I can paste it and bring it over to last name. And then I'm going to right click this box, select properties, and I need to update the field name and the tooltip and select OK. We would then do the same thing for phone number and email address, but let's go on to checkboxes and let's add these checkboxes in my pre-designed area. I can use the keyboard to try to line it up a little better. And again, I'm going to right click, open up the properties menu, and the field name here will be, do you have experience with accessibility? And this can also be my tooltip. And then again, we can set either required or read only and set the appearance of the checkbox and select OK. Let's go on to the signature field. I can simply add the signature button and place it where I want. You can drag and drop or simply place it. And we can right click, select properties, and again, add our field name, which will be signature, and our tooltip, sign the document. And we may want to make this one required and select OK. So now that we have some form fields in here, let's go ahead and finish adding the rest of these. I'm going to add my phone number and select OK. And then we can add our email address, right click, select properties, change our field name, and select OK. We can then copy these checkboxes, move them to the right location, and update the properties for those. Now that this document is a fillable form, if we wanted to add some additional fields in this file, let's say we forgot something, we can come over to the Edit Content tab, select Add Text, and we could add more information. This is another form area, and then we can go back to the form editor and then add in our text field. We can make it a little bit larger in this section. Right click, select properties, and we'll say another form. Please enter additional information. And then for the format on this one, we're gonna make it multi-line and select okay. All right, let's save out this document, and we can actually save it as many different file types. In this example, I'm going to save it as a searchable PDF document and select save. Next, I'm going to open up my form, my document within Adobe Acrobat. Let me move my floating head around. And I now have my field names entered in here. But for me, I like to make my documents accessible. So the next step would be to make this PDF form accessible. The rest of this video is going to go into how to make this PDF accessible. So if you're not interested in that part of it, feel free to skip onto one of my other videos linked below. Otherwise, let's jump right in. And to do that, I can start with opening up the tags menu, and all of my tags have been removed as this was previously a tagged document. So what I'm going to do is run this file through the Make Accessible Action Wizard by selecting Action Wizard and then Make Accessible. And from here, I'm going to select Start, and we can enter in our metadata. I'm going to leave this as is. We need to make this a searchable PDF. It already has form fields, so I can skip this step. We will set the reading language to English, and then it's going to find all images, the Accessibility Guy logo, save and close. And then lastly, it's going to run an accessibility check on the document. Now, I don't care about the accessibility checker yet. Let's go into the tags panel and see what came. All right, so we have a little bit of work here. The first thing I'm going to do is make this a document tag, and then we can begin to edit the structure of this tag file, of this tagged document. So my first text here, application, is gonna be an H1. Then we have a P tag, and we have our first name. All right, this isn't terrible, but we're missing a couple of P tags. So I'm gonna right click in the tags panel, select new tag, and create a couple of blank P tags that I can move some of this content around. And the first thing I want to move out is the phone number object reference. So this first P tag is gonna contain first name and the form object. And I need to use the reading order tool to separate the phone number text out because it is connected to this other content. All right, so I have phone number. I'm gonna Control X and paste it underneath my first name tag. And I now have this object reference that I need to paste. Now all object references need to have a form parent tag type. So I'm going to nest the phone number field inside of that. And now we need to do the same thing for last name. Last name is actually good. And then email address, and email address is also good. Let's check out our list item. We have a list with three items, and it doesn't quite appear that it marked all of the form fields properly, but it did mark some of them. All right, so the first one needs to be moved into the L body. So this first list item is going to have the label, our L body, which is the actual meat of the list, and then the form element. And the next one should have the same thing. So we have our label, our L body, but we're missing the form tag, and it's actually in the other list item. And then our last list item, the form element, is actually hidden in another form field, in another P tag. So what I did right now is I fixed the structure of this list. It actually doesn't even need to be a list, but I'm going to leave for now. And I made sure that all of my checkboxes were properly in the right location. And then we have our signature form field, and we have another form area. This appears to be tagged pretty decently, I'm surprised. All right, let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker and see what kind of trouble we're gonna get into. And it actually passes everything. That's fantastic. So we can save this document, and then let's open up the PAC 2021 checker, and let's make sure our document is WCAG compliant. I'm going to drop this file inside, and it looks like we have a failure on 1.3 adaptable. Let's check out what it is. Under perceivable info and relationships, the font is not embedded. So this is a pretty simple fix. We have to open up our pre-flight menu, and if I select the little wrench icon and type the word font, there is an option called embed missing fonts, and I'm going to select fix and then save the document. And now we can test it again. And we now have a WCAG 2.1 compliant form that was created from Abbyy FineReader and exported out into Adobe Acrobat. Now, if your goal is to create accessible files, I don't think you necessarily need to use Abbyy FineReader. However, it can be a great tool if it's something you're already using. So I hope you found this video useful. And remember, I can be your personal accessibility expert, and I hope to see you around here soon. Thank you for watching.